pound, like, no one's ever actually, like, unified 130. There's been a lot of Hall of Famers that have actually had one or two titles there and moved up. I mean, you can be the first one to actually unify 130 pounds, you know?
That's going to be dope, man. That's my vision. I want to unify the titles and then move up in weight. But right now, since I have the title at 130, bro, like, it's just maintaining it. I'm just keeping it as long as I can and as long as possible and then decide to go on there. But you're fighting at 122 right now, right?
Yeah, 122. Yeah. Yeah.
Damn, dude. I know I seen your – and you made it good, too, because you're nice and tall and you're slim, but you have a good build for 122 pounds because you're a lot bigger than these guys. These guys are probably walking around like at 130, but you're walking around a little heavier where you're able to when you make the weight, after the weigh-ins, you fill out and you're looking good.
Yeah, well, I started my career at 126, so you know, 130, 122. Obviously, as you know, weight's never easy making it, but I still feel strong. I think I still got like a good year to be realistically, and then 126, I can probably do for a couple years, and then hopefully, you know, I don't know, maybe 130. I don't know yet. It's one fight at a time, obviously, man. I cannot. Remember what I told you at the finest screen. You cannot overlook anybody, bro.
Anybody, man.
Yeah, I remember.
Especially in this sport, because everybody's hungry and everybody's wanting to take your fucking head off, bro. So you gotta take it fight by fight, and you can't take anybody lightly. And that's the thing that I learned too, because when I fought Gary Russell Jr., I felt like I took him a little lightly, because when I seen him, bro, like, he was small, like, he was like up to my chin. And, like, I seen him and how he built, I was like, man, like, I'm going to be able to fucking walk over this guy. Like, I'm going to be able to hurt him and stuff. But then when the fight came, bro, like, it was a lot more different because he's fast and he knows how to move and he was creating angles. And I was landing my body shots, but I wasn't able to be the fighter that I usually am because he was able to move around and then the referee would separate us in time where he would go back to the middle. So he had a really, really good game plan that fight, and I wasn't able to capitalize on it. So that's why It's always good never to underestimate anybody, man. You got to take every fight seriously.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, honest question. Did you get a little nervous for that fight?
For the Gary Russell?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, I did, man.
Yeah.
Not only because it was my first world title, but I was fighting the best guy in the division, and then also fighting on a whole different network, fighting at Maryland in his hometown. With all the, like, everything was, like, on his side, bro. So, it was already hard for me. Like, going into the fight, I was already losing by four or five rounds. So, I really had to like, either knock him out or hurt him. But, like I said, man, everything that happened in my career is a learning experience. And I just got to, you know, take it how it is and just adjust from here now.
Yeah, bro. I mean, because I saw your fight with Gary, and, it, like, it kind of looked like you were a little nervous. Because I can relate to you, bro. Because the Brave Vargas fight, but the only difference was that you were able to snap out of it towards like the middle of the last rounds. I'm pretty sure if you were to take that fight again, it would be a little bit different. Because obviously you learn. We're both more experienced now, and yeah, man.
Same with you too. Because it's just like, I was like a gun shy, and you were gun shy as well when you fought Ray Vargas, man. And when you were in the pocket too, you would land some good blows, but then you weren't able to like cut off the ring or get to him again, bro. Like, you were just fighting one similar style, like just one style where you weren't changing your speeds up. And that's the thing about Ray Vargas, because he wants to fight on the outside a lot. Where if you would have just got to him good and fought on the inside like how you do, man, you would have put a hurting on him.
I mean, dude, like we said, everything happens for a reason. You know, it sucks. I lost, and it sucks because, shit, I could have been a world champion. But obviously, like we said, everything, I let that one slide by. But I'm not gonna dwell on the past, bro. It's time to focus on the future, man. And I think 122. I think you know, everything goes good. I want to get one, possibly a couple more belts, and then go up to 126.
Yeah, 122 is your way, man. And then 126, after that, start making your way to 126 and getting those big names. But Golden Boy has a lot of fighters at 122 and 126, so you're going to be able to get some really good fights, man, in for yourself. So you just got to get the vision tight, bro.
Not only that, dude, like, I think honestly, I think since everything has gone down with all this quarantine, all these people that have gotten sick and unfortunately have died, you know, my heart goes out to those people. I think if the promoters, all the promoters would just, like, obviously keep this to heart, maybe, hopefully, we can start working together in the future. You know, that hopefully that would be something good and give the fight fans something they want to see, because there's a lot of fights to be made that can be made because, you know, something, you know, this promoter doesn't get along with this. I hope all this can make us realize, you know what, man, it's freaking, let's just let everything aside and just start focusing on these fights, man. That's the thing to do, man.
That's right, man. And I'm pretty sure it is. I'm pretty sure everybody is going to be able to get these fights that people want to deserve. Like, I want to see like Earl Spence fight Terrence Crawford. I want to see all these fights be made, man, because there's a lot of good fights that could be made in the boxing world if just these promoters are just put their ego down, man. Just put their ego down and just let all that other bullshit of business go to the side and let these fights happen for the fight fans and for us fighters as well, because we want to make a name for ourselves as well, and we want to fight the best. So might as well just put that ego aside and make the fights happen.
Yeah, of course, man. Like, fuck. Like, every time they've always given us a name, we've always accepted it. We've never been like, no. There was only one time where we were just like, no, you know what? Right now, it wasn't anything about the fighter in front of us. It was just the circumstances surrounding my team that we were like, hey, you know what? This is not the time. I can't get into it legally, but we couldn't do it. So that was the only time. Besides that, man, I just want to tell everybody around. I know you too. I've never ducked anybody, nor have I ever will duck anybody. We're here to fight the best, man. And hopefully this thing can just push the promoters to push the fights that the people want, man. Because honestly, I think you can do 130 for a while. I can really see you fighting for Chet Gancio again, you know. Rene Alvarado again. I can see you fighting who else is at 130? Farmer again. And then maybe move up to 135. Man, I think you still got a good 4 or 5 fights left at 130.
Yeah, facts, man. That's the thing. Like, I can make 130 easy. So just if the fights are gonna be made, and if the guys want to fight me, and if we can unify the titles, I'm gonna do that shit. But my main focus right now is I kind of want to fight Adam Mattis, because Adam Mattis is trying to come out of not retirement, but he's saying that his eye's better and he wants to fight at 130. So that's the guy that I really want to face, because it's a guy that I grew up watching. Me and you both grew up watching, and we know that he's a hell of a fighter, and he's a type of guy that is going to bring in a lot of fans, and it will be an exciting fight. So I want to fight Amin Amadis next, man. That's the guy that I really want to face next.
Who do you think the fights would want you to fight next?
Who?
I want to see some comments. Who?
I want guys, to see all right.
Who
yeah,
do you
guys.
Guys want Georgia to fight next?
Who do you guys want me to fight next, and who do you guys want Ronny Rios to fight next?
Yeah, man, that's a good one, man.
Yeah, and then also we're also going to be doing some questions. So if you guys want to answer some questions, I got this question little thing. So we'll start answering you guys' questions as well. Let me see.
They said Ronny fight Jojo. We're not even in the same weight class.
People just trying to start up some beef, Ronny. That's why.
Yeah, it's funny, man. It's like some of the stuff that you like some people post. They were like, oh, look, coaches are like, all I want is Ryan to get to the gym on time.
Why you always late, bro? You always late to the gym?
Yeah, let me see,
too. I'm always late, bro. But
no, I'm always the first one there, man.
Oh, I'm always late, man.
Ryan versus MJ. Michael Jordan. Ryan Garcia.
Ryan Garcia. Class. Yep. I'll fight Ryan Garcia, too.
Ryan. Oh, Emilio Sanchez.
All right, let's see. Who won? Ronny, I've got some questions right here, so I'm gonna let you answer them, okay?
Okay, go for it, man.
All right, so this guy, Jay Franco, he wrote, how are you, and how are you training in the quarantine?
I'm good. Thanks, Franco. I appreciate it. And we are training. We're training at a closed location right now for quarantine, but it's just me, a couple of the guys. You know, we're taking this very seriously, but we're also taking this very safe as well too, because we know some people that have gone sick. So you know, you can never be too safe. But like I told Jojo, man, we're just getting ready to fight the best fights. You know, give the fans the best fights we could. because at the end of the day, this is boxing, man. I don't want to freaking, I don't want to just fight anybody just for a payday. I want to be considered a Hall of Famer. And then you're not going to get there by fighting the least best fights, you know? Oh, look, I saw a comment. Jojo versus Gary Russell, too. That'd be a good one.
I want that shit, too. I want that work. I want that work again.
Yeah.
Let's see. All right. This one. Oh, this is a good question. Are you guys both willing to fight without fans? What do you think about that, Ronny?
Yeah, man. Yeah, because at the end of the day, your fans are going to be able to see you.
Yeah, I think so, too. I think that I'll be willing to fight without fans because it's basically like training, man. It's just like sparring when we go to when we're always constantly sparring. There's only about like 5-6 people there in the gym as well. So I don't think it's going to be any different for us as far as like fighting. It's going to be kind of different because when you look out, you're not going to see any fans, but you're still going to know that people are going to watch. People are still going to be streaming live and stuff like that. So I think it's still going to be the exact same thing. I just love to fight. So fans or without fans, as long as I'm fighting, as long as we're still getting this show on the road, let's make it happen.
Yeah, like I was telling Hector, I was like, I mean, why would, because he asked me, like, would you want to fight without fans? I was like, yeah. I was like, if they want to watch the fights, obviously, might as well give them an entertainment, man. Like, everybody's bored at home. Everybody's bored at home. I know I'm bored at home. Damn. So, nothing's going to bring people more than boxing or sports.
All right. This goes for both of you. Who's the top 2 pound for pound?
Damn, that's a good one. Man, that's a good one. Who would you say?
For me, pound for pound right now? I think pound for pound, I personally think it would be Canelo Alvarez and Tyson Fury. Tyson Fury is a fucking – he's a beast, man. He knows how to fight on the outside. He's fast. He's elusive. He's big, and he's strong. And his last performance just – like. Hands down, just already showed me that he's one of the best in our generation. And I think that he's going to provide many more fights. And his story and everything that he's been through, man, is just – no. I just know how ambitious he is, and I know how hungry he is. So I think Tyson Fury is the pound for pound, and Canelo Alvarez. Canelo Alvarez is just a whole nother level, man. He's built, he's stocky, he's fast, he knows how to counter, and he's strong and very, very powerful. So I think these guys are my –
Yeah, I also think Terrence Crawford and I also think Lomachenko are up there too.
Yeah, Terrence Crawford and Lomachenko, they're up there as well.
Yeah, they're up there too. Spence, you know. So it's kind of hard. It's just like, it's very hard to answer that question because it's.
There's a lot of fighters out, man.
Yeah.
All right, what's that? Who is your favorite current boxer and why?
I might have to say Jojo's up there. You're up there, bro. You're up there because you came through adversity. Like I said, you should have been 2-time champion. I might have to say Alexis Roach is up there, too. My brother. Yeah,
I think my favorite current fighter right now, Earl Spence. Earl Spence.
Spence is good, too. Spence is real good.
I do the dog, man.
My hat goes off to Spence because I think Mikey Garcia is a very good fighter. I think Garcia deserves to be one of the top pound for pound fighters too because he always comes through. Obviously, he didn't come through for Spence, and obviously, I just think that weight class was. I mean, maybe it was just too small for that weight class, but I think Mikey Garcia is another pound for pounder too that we forgot to mention for hand for sure.
Mikey Garcia is a hell of a fighter, but Earl Spence was just way too big for him, man. Just going into that fight, he's just. Way too big. He walks around about like 180, man. So he drops down to 147. He's a big ass dude. He's a fucking strong motherfucker. So just that type of size difference, man, is just a mismatch.
Man, 180? Damn.
That dude's like me, man. He's fucking stuck as shit. Weird. I don't know how he makes it, bro. Like he has a fucking like no. When he makes weight, bro, he's just shredded, bro. Like it's insane.
Damn. So Mikey Garcia versus Pacquiao. That'd be a good one. I like that fight. Guns. I like that. Mikey Garcia, that would be a good fight.
This one, Eli Seckbach. He said, what you think of Mike Tyson? Who should he face?
Man, that guy got in shape. They put it before picture and after that guy, and I saw him meeting. That guy looks in shape. I think he should fight. I heard he wants to fight Randall Holyfield. I want to see that one, man, just because he's beaten him twice. I actually do want to see that one.
I think Mike Tyson, I think a fight with him and Andy Ruiz, that shit will be a good-ass fight. Oh.
That is a good one.
That would be a good-ass fight, him and Andy Ruiz. That would be a good one. Because yeah. Andy Ruiz, he's aggressive and he's stocky as well. And Mike Tyson, he's Mike Tyson, man. He's a fucking KO artist. So I think that's a good fight right there. Andy Ruiz and Mike Tyson will be an exciting fight, especially right now.
Yeah, yeah. Or Roy Jones Jr., I don't know. I think Roy Jones Jr. is real good, but I just think he's too small. Too small for Tyson.
Let's see. We got a couple more questions right here, guys. They said, "Are we cousins? Because we have the same nose." We just get punched for a living.
I know, man. Hey, do you still use a headgear with the face part?
I never use that shit. Do you?
No, I used to, not anymore, man. I started going regular.
Dude, the crazy thing about me is like I don't even have a bone in my nose, bro. Like it's just like. When I touch it, it just goes straight down. Like, there's no bone in between my nose at all. So, I don't know if it's because I got punched so many times or what. But, yeah, we have weird-ass noses.
Yeah, we do. I think my coach messed up my nose, man. I think he's on here, too. Hector, you messed up my nose with a freaking – what was that spray? It was in the amateurs. I was sick, and my nose was really congested. And that guy put – what's that? Over-the-counter medicine that you have to – nasal spray?
Oh, yeah, that nasal spray.
Yeah, he put nasal spray, and it said only put once, and that guy did it, like, six times.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so my nose has not been the same. I blame Hector. Like,
yeah, man, fuck you guys. Man, fuck you guys, bro. You guys are clowning on our noses. That's messed up.
That is true, man. My nose is big. That's what my wife's always making fun of me. And my gat, too.
Let's see. Who's a better matchmaker, Mr. Diaz or Mr. Gomez?
I'm going to have to go with Mr. Diaz.
Mr. Diaz, Robert Diaz?
Yeah.
To be honest, I really never, like, seen Eric Gomez do matchmaking that much. I've always went through Robert Diaz. So, with me, Robert Diaz, he's a good matchmaker. But I know that Eric Gomez, he knows boxing, like just like Robert Diaz, man. So I'm pretty sure that if you were to make some fights happen, he would be a good matchmaker as well.
Yeah, I agree with you, bro. I've never actually seen him make any fights. It's always Robert Diaz. I mean, I could be wrong, but it's always Diaz and what's his album? Yeah, well, just Diaz and Rosso. I think Rosso got into it pretty soon, too.
Oh, yeah, Rosso's matchmaking now, too.
Rosso, man, if you watch it,
Rosso's on his shit now, bro.
Yeah, he's been doing a good job.
All right. What's your favorite sneaker in your collection?
Yeah, honestly, bro, I'm very cheap when it comes to shopping. All my nice sneakers, presents from my wife. So I would have to go either the Burberry or the Gucci sneakers.
Burberry's nice. I think mine's will probably be my Olympic retros. I got them in London, bro.
How much you pay?
They're my Jordans. I think I got them for about like 220 pounds, so they're kind of expensive at that time because they released early. But I got them for a good deal. I still got them too.
Hold on, what's the most you ever spend on a shoe?
The most I've ever spent on a shoe, I think, was like $1,400 on some Louis Vuittons. Yeah. 14, and they're all fucked up now, dude. That's the last time I'm ever gonna buy Louis Vuittons like that.
I saw a comment right now that I'm the mandatory for that one champion. They haven't said anything. I'm the mandatory for Figueroa. That's the last time.
Let's see.
I remember you wore those, dude. For a practice.
Huh? Yeah, I did. Oh, yeah, dude. I got like four pairs of those, dude, man. But now they're just too much, man. And they're all fucked up. So I don't even wear them anymore.
Honestly, man, I respect you. But when I saw those shoes, I'm like, you know what the hell Jojo's doing, man.
That's not my style, dude. That's not my style anymore.
Man. Versus McGregor. Oh. It depends. Boxing fight or UFC fight? If it's a UFC fight, I think McGregor. If it's a boxing fight,
yeah, I'm going to have to go with De La Hoya, too. I think De La Hoya is going to
Dalloway will sleep McGregor. I think he'll stop him. He's a bad motherfucker, Dalloway, man. All right, we're gonna answer one more question, guys, and then we're gonna get off this live. So, let's see.
Preferred? I still don't know, but I don't think it's June. I think June's out of the group, man. I'm about to say July or August.
Oh, someone said, what are you trying to do after you retire from boxing?
I started when I kind of took a little break from boxing. I started doing those things. So right now, I'm excited to get my test and agent, yeah. So that's pretty cool. I also want to do flipping on my own, too. You know, probably investing some property. Obviously, you can't go wrong with that.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, when I retire from boxing, I want to have my couple investments, bro, and I want to invest in a couple of real estate as well and a couple of homes. And then I want to actually start my own, I don't know if my management or my promotional company. I want to start, you know, managing fighters and just managing